That sentiment echoed by Moore last night in his victory speech.
Together we can make America great. We can support the president. Don't let anybody in the press think that because he supported my opponent that I do not support him and support his agenda.
Meantime, President Trump praising Moore's victory, tweeting this morning, spoke to Roy Moore of Alabama last night for the first time. Sounds like a really great guy who ran a fantastic race. He will help to make America great again. And there you have it. What did you make of all the
I have to tell you that they are both friends of mine, Chief Justice Moore and Senator Strange. I was very strongly in the Moore camp because I'm sort of the anti-establishment type myself, as Marie and our colleagues know. But I think the president made a mistake by violating Ronald Reagan's 11th commandment, thou shalt not campaign against a fellow Republican. It's one thing to support a fellow Republican in a primary. It's another thing to bring the machinery of the federal government, including your vice president, down there on the weekend before the primary. I think this is a rejection of a different Donald Trump, because Donald Trump and Roy Moore are very similar in their attitudes about government, about the establishment. I'm befuddled as to why he was on the Luther Strange side, unless he had to make a deal with Mitch McConnell, who is also a big loser here.
I thought that too. I thought that might have been in the works. Maybe it wasn't any sort of a formal deal like he did with the Democrats, but maybe it was one of those kind of wink-wink things of, look, there's a guy running. He doesn't really think that the state's going to flip anyway. Like, it's going to remain Republican. So what would it hurt to have a little political mojo behind this guy running?
Doesn't a Democrat stand a chance there? Is it a serious Democrat?
It is a serious Democrat. No, it is.
Wow.
It is.
Well, it's Alabama.
It's interesting. Hello. Carl